14,000 BTU portable air conditioners are not really 14,000 BTU portable air conditioners. They lose quite a bit of cooling capacity due to their inherent inefficiencies. Now, the two inefficiencies that stand out the most are the heat that the unit adds through its ducting and the heat that the unit adds to the room via infiltration air. So what exactly are those two sources of heat? The first is easy to explain. The unit exhausts hot air through its duct on the back here. And as it exhausts that hot air, the hose itself heats up. And that heat is radiated back into the room that the unit is actively working to cool. So that heat reduces the unit's actual cooling capacity. The other source of heat is a little bit more difficult to understand. It involves the outdoor air getting pulled into the room. How this works is the portable AC unit pulls in air to cool its condenser. On the back of the unit, you can see it right here. It pulls in air through that grill to cool the condenser, and then that air is heated up, and then it's exhausted through the duct out through the window. And as it pulls in that air, it's not actively working to replace that air. There's no source of replacement of air as air is getting pulled out of the room. So what ends up happening is you create an area of low pressure inside of the room. And by comparison, the outdoor air is at a much higher pressure. So what ends up happening is that the hot outdoor air is constantly wanting to get pulled into the room due to that pressure gradient that's created. And that hot outdoor air is called infiltration air. So that infiltration air wants to come into the room. It does in fact find ways to come into the room. And when it does, it adds heat back into the room, reducing the actual cooling capacity of the unit. So in the past, those two major inefficiencies would not be accounted for. And that's why a unit like this unit on the table here would be considered a 14,000 BTU portable air conditioner. It would be said to have a cooling capacity of 14,000 BTUs, but not accounting for those inefficiencies. Now, in recent times, we have new standards for measuring BTUs, and that new standard is called seasonally adjusted cooling capacity. And using seasonally adjusted cooling capacity, we can now see the true cooling capacity of these units, because seasonally adjusted cooling capacity, SAC for short, actually subtracts the heat added by the ducting. It subtracts the heat added by infiltration air from the overall BTU number to give us a more accurate BTU number that we can use to compare different units. Now, this is a very important point. In the past, you would walk into a home goods store or you would shop online and you would compare different 14,000 BTU units and you would have no idea between the actual cooling capacity between these different units. They would all simply be 14,000 BTU units. So you would think, okay, this is a 14,000 BTU unit. It covers this much square feet and therefore it is just as good at cooling as this other 14,000 BTU unit or this other 14,000 BTU unit. And you would really just go with the unit that was the cheapest, or maybe a particular unit would have better reviews based on its noise output or its size or any other factors, but it would never be cooling capacity that would distinguish one model from another. Well, that was the past. Today we have seasonally adjusted cooling capacity to see the actual difference in performance between these different units. So let's take a look at all of the 14,000 BTU units currently on the market and see how we can distinguish between those different models. So as we look at the list we have here in front of us, we see quite the range in seasonally adjusted cooling capacity. What you'll notice first of all is that the most efficient units are somewhere around 10,000 BTUs, 9,500 BTUs for the second most efficient unit. On the flip side of things, you'll notice that the least efficient units are in the 7,500 BTU range. So already you can see a large discrepancy between the most efficient units and the least efficient units. And keep in mind that all of these units were previously simply called 14,000 BTU units. So at the lower end of the range, we have a unit from Black & Decker, a unit from Honeywell, a unit from Frigidaire. We have quite a number of different brands represented. We even have an LG unit at 8,000 BTUs on the seasonally adjusted cooling capacity scale. So we have a number of different brands represented, a number of different models represented. And the truth here is that we would not recommend any of these models based on that low seasonally adjusted cooling capacity. You are paying a premium for a 14,000 BTU unit. And for you to get that low of a cooling capacity when you're paying the 14,000 BTU price is simply not acceptable in our opinion. Now moving up to units that are at the higher end of the range, we have several interesting things to point out here. First of all is the fact that the Whynter ARC-14S is sitting at 8,900 BTUs on the seasonally adjusted cooling capacity scale. So the interesting thing here is that the Whynter is actually a dual hose unit. Now, earlier we talked about that whole infiltration air problem that single hose units create because they are exhausting air that they're not actively working to replace. Dual hose units don't have the same problem to the same extent because they are not using room air to cool the condenser. They are actually pulling on outdoor air to cool the condenser. And in doing so, they limit the pressure gradient that is created. Now, certain units do still pull in some air from the indoors to cool the condenser, even though most of the air that is used to cool the condenser is coming from the outdoors. There's still a little bit of air used from the conditioned room. So infiltration air is not completely eliminated, but it definitely is less of a problem with dual hose units. At least theoretically, it would appear to be so. However, what we see here is we see a 14,000 BTU dual hose unit in the winter here that is at a lower capacity, at a lower seasonally adjusted cooling capacity than multiple single hose units. So what that suggests is that even though the winter has this major advantage with its second hose, there are several disadvantages that it has as well, which pull it down to 8,900 BTUs compared to the higher BTUs for those top rated single hose units. And if you're interested more in the difference between single hose and dual hose units, we do have a video on that that we will link to in the description to this video. In any case, moving on to the higher capacity units here, we have the LG LP1419 IVSM, and we have the NewAir NAC14KWH02. Now, both of these units are relatively new to the market, and both of these units are the top performers in the category. The LG currently holds the title as having the most SACC BTUs of any unit currently on the market, and the NewAir is not far behind at 9,500 BTUs. So either one of these units are strongly recommended in the category for the sole reason that they have a high seasonally adjusted cooling capacity. The truth of the matter is that all of these units are large, all of these units are heavy, all of these units are similarly noisy. Really, on most fronts, these units are equal. The cooling capacity is that one differentiating factor that we can use to distinguish between different models and determine which are the best, and the NewAir and the LG stand out here. So in the 14,000 BTU category, our number one recommendation is the LG, and our number two recommendation is the NewAir.